Welcome to Oracle Marketing Cloud Help Center videos. In this video, I'll be demonstrating how to upload contacts in Eloqua. There are a number of reasons you may need to upload contacts to Eloqua. Maybe you just hosted an event and have a list of attendees, or maybe you've identified a bunch of outdated contacts you need to delete. Whatever your reason is, you can update a group of contacts at once using the upload wizard. First things first, you need to identify and compile your contacts into an upload file. The upload file can be a text or CSV file, or a Microsoft Excel spreadsheet. In your upload file, you will first need to identify the Eloqua contact fields you are going to include. Whether you are using a text-based file or a spreadsheet, the first line or row should list these fields. In a text file, separate the contact fields in both the heading line and subsequent contact lines using either a comma, a pipe, a semicolon, or a tab. Use one method of separation consistently. It is important that the contact fields be separated in the same fashion as the heading line, otherwise the fields will not be transferred into Eloqua correctly. If you're using a spreadsheet, fill out the table below the heading row. Whether you are using a delimited file or an Excel file, it is critical that your contacts have a unique identifier. Typically, the unique identifier of a contact is that contact's email address. The unique identifier is the contact field that Eloqua uses to differentiate contacts. Unique identifiers are used throughout Eloqua, such as with custom data objects. It is important to note that contacts without a unique identifier will not be added to the Eloqua contact database. To upload contacts, navigate to Audience, then click Contacts. This brings you to the Contacts Overview window. Click Upload in the top right corner. This opens the Contact Upload Wizard. In the Contact Upload Wizard, fill in the name of your contact upload. This name will show up in the notification email you'll receive after the upload is complete, so use a descriptive name to keep track of your process. For our video, we'll call it Sample Contact Upload. Then, select the import source file type. You can select either an Excel file or a delimited file. We'll be using an Excel file for this video. For the import purpose, select what action you wish to take with your uploaded contact. If you were deleting an active contact, you could have exported a segment and used that export for the update. But for this video, we'll simply be adding new contacts to the database using our spreadsheet. A preset is a way of keeping the same pattern of filling out the next steps on a local device. At the end of the wizard, we'll be given the option to save our setup as a preset. For now, we aren't going to use an upload setting preset, so we'll leave it as the default. Click on the cloud to begin browsing for the file. Select the file, then click Open. Once the file is read, you are given the opportunity to review the information, allowing you to ensure that all fields are correct. For our spreadsheet, we had email, first and last name, city, and country, all of which have been formatted correctly. So we're good to click Next Step. Step 3 allows you to map the contact fields to those in the Eloqua database. Eloqua will attempt to match source fields with existing Eloqua fields by name. Any fields without a match will need to be done manually. In our upload, the field email does not have an exact match in Eloqua. By double-clicking No Matches, we are able to select the corresponding Eloqua field. In this case, the email source field maps to the email address field in Eloqua. At the top of the wizard, we are given the opportunity to select which field uniquely identifies a contact. We're going to keep the default choice, email address. The All Fields Update type gives you the option to determine what happens with the uploaded information. If you select Always Update, the information in your upload will add the new contact and overwrite any existing information for existing contacts. If you select Update if blank, new contacts will be added and only blank fields of existing contacts will be updated. The Update if new value is not blank option will add any new contacts or information and will only change existing information if there is a new value in the upload file. The Custom option allows you to select a unique update type for each field. We're going to leave it as Set to Default. Your admin decides what occurs as the default setting. Once all fields are correctly mapped, select Next Step. The final step gives you the chance to type in the email address of the person you want to receive an email notification. This notification confirms the upload was successful. The email associated with the logged in account is filled in by default. Then, select whether you would like to add the contacts to a shared contact list. For example, if you're uploading an attendee list for an event, you may want to add the contacts to a shared list so your team can follow up later and thank them for their attendance. For this video, we won't add the contacts to a shared list. The last option is whether you want to save the details you have selected in the previous steps as a preset for your computer. We're going to pass on this option. When you're ready, click Finish. Eloqua then adds the contacts to the database and sends a confirmation email when the upload is complete. Depending on the size of the upload, this process may take longer than our demo. We are then returned to the Contacts Overview window. If we search for one of the contacts, they will be displayed in the table. By double-clicking on a contact, we are able to see their contact record. Now, one contact from our upload had an email address value of classified. Eloqua does not see this as a valid email address. In this instance, the email notification will inform us that there was one contact with an invalid email address. Due to this, the contact, in our case Phil Coulson, was not added to the contact database. We can confirm this by clicking the link in the email. As you can see, Phil was not added to our contacts. It is possible that some information may not update after you perform your upload. If this happens, there are a few common problems that may have occurred. First, it is possible that an invalid value was specified in one of the fields, such as the classified email from our sample upload. In this case, correct the value and re-upload the file, or add the contacts individually. Additionally, in step 3, you have the option to choose when contact fields are updated. In our demo, we chose to use the default upload type. If the contact fields did not update, make sure you selected the desired option, or check with your admin to see what your default is. If a contact was recently updated by your CRM, a manual upload may not update the contact record. This is because a manual upload usually has a lower data priority than other sources of contact data, such as from your CRM. To check the data priority, an admin can navigate to Settings and select Integrations under Platform Extensions. From the Inbound tab, select Management, then Data Priority Order. The priority for your data imports will be displayed in the area below. If the data priority is the cause of the problem, contact your administrator regarding the issue. And there we go! We've shown you how to upload contacts, and given you some things to try if you run into problems. There's a similar upload wizard to update accounts, so why not check it out? Or, if you're looking to do a more regularly occurring upload, why not check out the data export and import tool under Audience? In addition to the Eloqua Help Center, you can get a lot of great tips and tricks from the Topliners community. Thanks for watching.